कुछ बाकी है 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 नज़्र तो है पर सांस नहीं क्यों लफ्जों को एहसास नहीं कदमों को रुकना रास नहीं मंजिल मंजिल प्यास नहीं कुछ बाकी
Welcome to Dreamcatchers. Our special guest today is a young Kashmiri poetess who has won accolades for her work. She is also one of the star performers for upcoming New England Choice Awards on October 27. Let us meet Sunayana Kachroo. Sunayana, welcome. Thank you so much for coming on the show. Now, many people know you for your poetry, but you actually have a master's degree in computer science from Pune University. But you're always a poetess at heart, right?
Yeah, I think so.
And I read that your first poem was published when you were only 15 years old.
Right.
So how did that come about?
So first of all, thank you for inviting
me.
And as you said, a lot of people know me as a poetess.
Right. So
this would be first time I'm actually going back and looking at my life as a witness.
Yes.
So as you said, my first poem was published when I was 15. And it was titled Destined to Rise.
Oh my goodness, very appropriate.
But at that time I did not know that Maya Angelou has written something which has the same title,
okay.
Which I read much, much later.
Okay.
So I had written that poem and actually at my home, my father is someone who's always created this atmosphere where we would always read books, listen to music. That was our way of bonding. And so he would be listening to music all the time. He would be talking on movies. Mm-hmm. This is Bimal Roy's movie and some story around that. This is Guru Dutt and this is the song where he introduced this technique in the film industry. And so that atmosphere was always there. So I think somewhere it kind of was marinating in my mind.
It sowed a seed early on, right?
Yeah. So that environment was there and... That is the first time I had actually written something and I actually showed it to him and he said, well, you know, it's good, but you can improve it.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt it was fine.
You were 15, right?
Yes. Yeah. So I was 15 when you feel that what you're doing is the right thing to do. And so I actually sent it over to a local newspaper and they published it the way it was. And he was proud when he looked at it.
Okay.
Yeah. So that was the first time I realized that I can write.
And Gulzar has been a major influence on you, right?
For your poetry
and for you as a person, right?
Right. I think I'll have to probably step back a little bit.
Okay.
I don't usually talk a lot about him, but my biggest influence in the early years, and I think even till now, is Jagjit Singh Ji. So I think for years, I have only listened to his composition.
Which one is your favorite?
It's one of your favorites. I would say that probably it's more relevant today. And at this moment, I would say, Dushman ko bhi seene se lagana nahi bhule. Hum apne buzurgon ka zamana nahi bhule.
I really like that.
And there are many more.
Okay. Now, in the last few years since you moved to America, you have pretty much focused a lot on poetry, script writing, right?
Right.
So. What gave you the courage to do that?
to leave a job and then do this? I don't think, even today, I have the courage to say that, yeah, this is what I'm doing for good. But I think um, it actually the courage came from my family, my husband, my mother-in-law. They have, even today they tell me that, you know, go forward, and you know, when is your next book coming up, and what are you doing, what. So the courage came from there, and I had been writing on and off on Facebook and sharing it, and some friends would say, wow, this is good, and I thought, oh really, maybe it is good. Then I started following many other writers and realized that, you know, there's so much to write and there's so much to think about. And as and when I started sharing my stuff on social media, a lot of my friends who were my schoolmates and my college mates, they started commenting and telling me, why don't you all put it all together somewhere?
Right.
And that's how you know, my book came about.
This is so beautiful, Waqt Se Pare.
And the idea of the book was not to create just another book. We wanted to actually collaborate, incorporate pictures as well. And that's where a lot of the pictures are there.
Right.
So to create
right.
poetry as an experience.
Right. You like taking photographs as well,
I do, yeah. I do.
And some of your recent work has been so beautiful. Of course, I've known you for the last few years. Ekal song is Kal Ho Gana.
Ekal Hogana is a question, and then Ekal Hogana is a solution.
Absolutely. Yeah. That is so beautiful.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, that's something which is very close to my heart, because just the thought that there are millions of children that Ekal supports, and this may give them an opportunity or inspiration to do something. And I've collaborated with Anuradha Palakurthi on that. I'm doing some more work with her.
Yes, she's sung it beautifully too.
Yes, absolutely.
And Sonu Nigam also has sung one of your songs,
yes,
right?
Yes,
one
yeah.
of your compositions. Do you want to share that with the viewers?
Yeah, so it's for a film called Half Widow, which is going to be released soon. And there's a song that I have written. It's called Kuch Baaqi Hai. So as you say, that there's more to life.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So wherever you are, if it's good or bad, trying to look forward and say, maybe there's something better
and
coming along.
Kuch Baaqi Hai sounds so good. It gives you so much hope.
Right.
And
it's a song of hope.
That's wonderful. Yeah. And you've been doing some script writing for movies as well, right?
Right. I just have, last few years, I've been collaborating with a production company which is based in LA and Kashmir, called Renzo Films, and I'm collaborating with the director, Danish Renzo. One of the things that we realized was happening in Kashmir was that a lot of people are making a lot of movies or documentaries in Kashmir.
Right.
But what we felt was missing was that the aspect of you know, bringing hope back. Yes, we should definitely acknowledge what is happening, but what after that?
Right.
So we wanted to bring that aspect, and we realized that we will be, we'll try to be part of the solution. And that is the first movie that we have just done, Half Widow. And the trailer was released, and we received amazing amount of support from media, and a lot of people liked it. People are actually desperate to see it.
It's a beautiful, the trailer looks so nice. I'm looking forward
to it. Yeah, and then Sonu ji has sung this song, and he has always, even before this, we had done one short film, which received a lot of awards. It was actually featured in Cannes Film Festival, in the short film corner. So he supported in that project also, and this project also, so like working with him.
So what drives you, Sunayana?
I'm a very restless person. So when I read some of my old work, I feel that's very blah. So
Bechain Atma.
Bechain Atma, yeah, yeah. So I think I'm looking for, and I also look at a lot of new writers in you know, Hindi film industry. Like I read recently Amitabh Bhattacharya's beautiful songs that he's been writing.
What do you want to do in the next 5 years or in long term?
I actually do not know. I think I have to take a refuge of Sahir's word when he say, "Main zindagi ka saath
nibhata chala gaya."
So whatever comes to me, which I feel aligns with my values.
Okay.
It's very important that it aligns with my values. So I will go with that. So that also means saying no to a lot of projects.
Absolutely.
And that's also important.
Now you are one of our star performers in the upcoming New England Choice Awards on October 27.
Right.
And this is an award show where we honor the achievers of our community. And of course, our struggles are very unique. So is there something special that you're composing for that?
See, when first of all, you know, I would be looking forward to meet these people. Yes. I looked at the list of the people that New England is honoring. Right. And it's just like it's a galaxy of stars.
Absolutely.
I've always had this thought that when I look at a person, what they have achieved, what they have accomplished, I would also like to know what they have overcome.
Absolutely.
I would like to know that.
That's so what inspires you.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right. Because success or the celebration is a very fleeting moment. Mm-hmm. So what has happened in their journey? What was their journey? Have they touched other people? What is it that they have overcome? So that gives us an opportunity, and me as well, to sit there and see and understand what they have done. So I'm looking forward to, you know, write something around that and be able to present it that day.
And sometimes when you get an award, people say, you know, it's an overnight thing, but there's years and years of labor that goes into making you an overnight sensation as well.
Yeah, because when you are when a meteor is close to the sun, that's the only time it's visible. But it has been traveling for eons.
We just don't know.
Science tells you that. Go to science.
It's always nice to have a woman of science who's so creative and writes poetry.
That is something which I've seen from Gulzar Sahab. He weaves a lot of this galactic and science and universal stuff. Science, a lot of science, there's a lot of science that he weaves into his poetry, which I like how he cleverly does it. And creates a layer over his under his poetry where, you know, all of the science
is
there.
A complete living legend.
Oh, totally,
So on that note, would you recite something for our viewers today?
Sure. I mean, I always have this, because I'm a poet, so I have these interesting incidents where people come to me and say, yaar ek kavita suna do.
Aap suna do.
To us baat pe wo jo ek hota hai, hamesha log poochte hain kavita suna do, us pe maine kuch likha
hai. Acha, very nice.
So main koshish karungi yaad karne ki aur sunane ki ki तुम कहते हो कविता लिख दो, तुम कहते हो कविता लिख दो, मुझे खून बहाना पड़ता है. तुम कहते हो कविता लिख दो, मुझे खून बहाना पड़ता है, शब्दों की खींचा तानी में नब्जों का धागा कटता है. तुम कहते हो कविता लिख दो, मुझे खून बहाना पड़ता है, शब्दों की खींचा तानी में नब्जों का धागा कटता है. उसकी हर बात बयां करके, अब जो भी आपका म्यूज है जिस पे आपने लिखा है या जो टॉपिक पे लिखा है, यू कैन राइट द सिम्टम्स, यू आर अ डॉक्टर, राइट, यू कैन राइट द सिम्टम्स बट नॉट रिवील द सोर्स ऑफ द पेन, नॉट नेम देम, दैट्स द दैट्स व्हाट पोएट्री इज ऑल अबाउट फॉर मी. कि उसकी हर बात बयां करके फिर नाम मिटाना पड़ता है, आतिशबाजी आतिशबाजी खुद को भी जलाना पड़ता है, आतिशबाजी आतिशबाजी खुद को भी जलाना पड़ता है, जो लफ्ज़ों से नहीं बहता आँखों से बहाना पड़ता है, जो लफ्ज़ों से नहीं बहता आँखों से बहाना पड़ता है, जेवर नहीं तावीज़ है ये, जेवर नहीं तावीज़ है ये, पर्दों में छुपाना पड़ता है. तुम कहते हो अरे कविता लिख दो, मुझे खून बहाना पड़ता
है. क्या बात है. Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
And we look forward to seeing you in the next few weeks.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.